Hey, Dee Dee, you gonna make art with me today? You're gonna make art with me, Chica Marie? Are you? Are you? Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Hello, everyone. We're here again at my happy cocoon. We are going today to transform this wonderful paper bag that has been let out. And I'm going to transform this into a wrapping paper for my niece's graduation gift for her bike, which she's going to be using at school. So it's kind of a weird shaped item that really, if you try to wrap it with the flimsy wrapping paper, this will be more special because I'm gonna make it customized just for her. Okay, the first thing that I'm going to do is cover it up with gesso. I'm not going to bore you with that, but you will just know that I will be doing that, and I'll show you when I'm done. So the next step I did was, after covering it with gesso, splashed some color, this green it's called aquamarine and satin cream, and I might even do a little bit of blue. You want to keep your background pretty light, because if you're going to do forms and figures, you want you don't want the dark paint to overpower and lose your figure, and you won't be able to put anything light on top. So it's always a good idea to do lighter first. And I just let this dry, and then I'm going to draw something on there and perhaps maybe stamp some stuff with a rubber stamp randomly all over. So now it's already transformed into something that does not even look like a paper bag anymore, because of the nice coloring that you have. Just make sure that you get all the paint that you splattered on there spread out. There we go. Actually, the way it is, you can really use it now, but you know, if you want to go a little further than that, then you're welcome to do that. So here's a sketch of the girl that I'm going to be painting. Of course, I measured like where the item would be wrapped around, and then just marked it on either side where I should start and end, right here. And that's going to be pretty much the placement of the face.
Thank you.